Okay, here we have a works cited page that you want to do a hanging indent on. There's a couple things to keep in mind. You want to make sure that you can see your ruler. If you can't see the ruler, go to View, Show Ruler should be clicked. The second thing is for entries that are more than one line, you want to make sure you haven't used the Enter key. So after 72 period, you'd have a space and then Booth. If you hit Enter to get this on the next line, it's not going to know that that's part of the line before it, so it's not going to do the indent right. From here forward, we're going to assume that the lines that belong together don't have an enter key used. The enter key happens here and here, etc. So select the entire area that you want, just left mouse key and then drag down, and then take your cursor up to the ruler. You'll see a horizontal line and a triangle. Right now, they act together, so just left click on them anywhere and drag them to the right half an inch. You'll know it's a half an inch because that number above the two symbols are going to show you 0.5. You let go. So this indented everything. We're halfway there. But now the trick is that you drag it back to the left, but just grab the top part, the little rectangle, and go back to zero. And there you have a hanging indent. The beginning of every line has no indent, but if there's a subsequent line, like the third entry, it'll indent the subsequent lines. You go all the way down to the bottom, even if it's more than one subsequent line, it'll give those a hanging indent. So there you go. It's not too bad once you know how to do it. It's just learning the trick of how to apply it. And I hope that was helpful.